In 2017, astronomers observed something extraordinary, an object from another star system speeding through our solar system. They named it Oumuamua, a Hawaiian word meaning a messenger from afar arriving first. However, as quickly as it appeared, it was gone. This elongated object was moving too fast for us to capture. What little we observed defied explanation. It wasn't a comet, as it had no tail. It wasn't an asteroid, as its shape was far too unusual. Then, as it exited our solar system, it unexpectedly sped up. This series of anomalies ignited intense debate within the scientific community. Now, scientists and engineers are proposing plans to chase down Oumuamua. Could we design a probe capable of catching up with Oumuamua? Would such a mission be worth it? Let's break it down. Before Oumuamua, every object astronomers had observed in the solar system originated from within the solar system itself. However, on October 19, 2017, astronomers using the Pan-STARRS 1 telescope in Hawaii detected Oumuamua. Initially, it was classified as a comet, then reclassified as an asteroid, and ultimately labeled an interstellar object, meaning it had come from beyond our solar system. Unlike objects bound to the Sun, which follow elliptical orbits, Oumuamua traveled along a hyperbolic trajectory. This indicated it wasn't gravitationally bound to our solar system. It came from elsewhere and would never return. Moreover, its velocity as it exited the solar system, about 87 kilometers per second relative to the Sun, was far too high for it to have originated here. Trajectory analysis suggested that Oumuamua originated from the Lyra constellation, though it showed no clear connection to any nearby star. This implies that Oumuamua may have been traveling through interstellar space for millions, or even billions of years before entering our solar system. Its discovery confirmed that objects from other star systems can and do wander into ours, opening an exciting new frontier in astronomy. However, this was only the beginning of the mystery. Oumuamua's peculiar properties raised even more questions about its origin, composition, and nature. Oumuamua wasn't a simple spherical or irregularly shaped rock like most asteroids or comets. Instead, it had an extremely elongated or flattened shape, with one side reflecting significantly more light than the other as it rotated. Estimates suggest it had an unusual length-to-width ratio of about 10 to 1, with a length of approximately 400 meters and a width and thickness of around 40 meters. The exact shape of Oumuamua remains a topic of debate within the scientific community. It may have been cigar-shaped, long and thin, but naturally forming such shapes is difficult, so this explanation is considered less likely. Alternatively, it could have been pancake-shaped, like a flat, thin disk. This pancake shape is also more consistent with some explanations for Oumuamua's strange behavior, which we'll explore next. You see, objects moving through space are primarily influenced by gravity. As Oumuamua passed the Sun, it followed a predictable gravitational trajectory, slingshotting around the Sun and heading out of the solar system. However, its velocity increased more than gravity alone could explain. This acceleration was unexpected in an object lacking a propulsion system or external force. For a comet, unexplained acceleration is typically caused by outgassing, when sunlight heats the ice on the comet's surface, turning it into gas and ejecting material into space. This process creates a small thrust, effectively giving the comet a slight push. If Oumuamua were outgassing, scientists would expect to see a visible tail or detect a gas cloud. However, observations showed no evidence of outgassing and no visible tail. Another hypothesis suggested that Oumuamua's acceleration was caused by solar radiation pressure. This phenomenon occurs when photons from the Sun exert force on an object, similar to how wind pushes a sail. For this to be possible, the object would need to be extremely lightweight and have a large surface area, like a thin sheet or disk resembling a light sail, a theoretical technology for spacecraft propulsion. This idea gained traction because it supported the hypothesis that Oumuamua might be pancake-shaped rather than cigar-shaped. A thin, flat object would be more responsive to solar radiation pressure. While plausible, this explanation raised new questions. Objects shaped like a light sail are not known to form naturally in our solar system. Could Oumuamua have been created through exotic processes in another star system, or was it an artifact of something artificial? For solar radiation pressure to account for the acceleration, Oumuamua would need to be composed of an exceptionally lightweight material, such as porous carbon or frozen nitrogen. However, this type of composition is highly unusual for natural objects. The unusual acceleration, combined with its shape and lack of a tail, led some researchers to consider the possibility that Oumuamua wasn't a natural object. Avi Loeb proposed that it might be a piece of alien technology. It could be a defunct light sail from an advanced civilization designed to harness solar radiation for propulsion. Alternatively, it might be an alien probe that had drifted through space for eons, potentially damaged or no longer functional. While most scientists remain skeptical of the alien hypothesis, they agree that Oumuamua's acceleration was highly unusual and requires further study. Another theory suggested that Oumuamua was made of solid hydrogen ice, which sublimates invisibly when heated by sunlight. If hydrogen outgassed in this way, it wouldn't produce a detectable tail, possibly explaining the acceleration without leaving visible evidence. However, this idea has its weaknesses. Hydrogen ice is fragile and unlikely to survive the long journey through interstellar space without evaporating. Additionally, it relies on the assumption that large hydrogen icebergs exist, despite no observational or theoretical evidence supporting their presence in interstellar environments. By the time Oumuamua was detected, it was already leaving the solar system. Unfortunately, this left us with too little time to study it in detail. Now, the scientific community is exploring plans to catch up to it or intercept future interstellar objects that enter our solar system. The Initiative for Interstellar Studies launched Project Lyra to evaluate the feasibility of sending a spacecraft to Oumuamua. The challenges are numerous and complex. First, Oumuamua is traveling at a velocity of approximately 26 kilometers per second relative to the Sun. Any spacecraft attempting to intercept it would need to exceed this velocity, requiring either advanced propulsion systems or highly efficient gravity assist maneuvers, such as slingshots around Jupiter or the Sun. Second, Oumuamua is now far beyond the orbit of Pluto, and continuing to move away at an increasing distance. Even with a highly optimized trajectory, a spacecraft launched today would take decades to catch up. This requires systems capable of withstanding the harsh conditions of deep space for extended periods. Third, the window of opportunity to launch a mission capable of intercepting Oumuamua is closing. A launch within the next few years is critical to intercept it with manageable energy and time requirements. Precise mission design is essential to ensure the spacecraft's trajectory aligns with Oumuamua's future location. The proposed mission design for Project Lyra to intercept Oumuamua incorporates a range of innovative strategies. The mission is expected to take 20 to 30 years, depending on the propulsion system and trajectory selected. While Project Lyra is evaluating several potential trajectories, a few primary strategies stand out. One key approach is the solar Oberth maneuver. In this strategy, the spacecraft would first be launched toward Jupiter or another large planet to perform a gravity assist maneuver. This assist would redirect the spacecraft toward the Sun while increasing its velocity significantly. The spacecraft would then approach the Sun to an extremely close distance, between 3 and 10 solar radii. At its closest point, the spacecraft would execute a propulsion burn. The Oberth effect makes propulsion more efficient at high velocities because the added kinetic energy from the burn is proportional to the square of the velocity. At this point, the spacecraft's velocity is at its maximum due to the Sun's gravity, allowing it to achieve the greatest possible acceleration for the least amount of fuel. After the burn, the spacecraft would be redirected onto an interstellar trajectory, matching or exceeding Oumuamua's speed and enabling an eventual rendezvous. One obvious challenge is the extreme heat and radiation near the Sun. This requires advanced heat shield materials and technology, similar to or exceeding those used in NASA's Parker Solar Probe. This will be difficult to achieve while maintaining low mass and functionality. An alternative strategy is the Jupiter Oberth maneuver, which involves a gravity assist from Jupiter combined with a propulsion burn at the point of closest approach to the planet. This method is less technically demanding, as it avoids the extreme heat and radiation near the Sun. However, the velocity increase from a Jupiter flyby is typically less than what can be achieved with a solar flyby. As a result, the spacecraft would take longer to intercept Oumuamua, extending the mission timeline. Studies have identified potential trajectories using the Jupiter-Oberth maneuver with proposed launch windows between 2026 and 2033, resulting in mission durations of approximately 26 years. Another promising strategy focuses on high-performance propulsion systems. One of the most innovative concepts is the use of solar sails, ultra-light reflective sheets that harness sunlight pressure for propulsion. By deploying the sails close to the sun, a spacecraft could gain tremendous speed without consuming fuel. This technology is already being tested in projects like the Planetary Society's Light Sail, offering a simple, efficient, and elegant method to achieve high velocities over time. Another promising approach is nuclear thermal propulsion, or NTP, which uses a small nuclear reactor to heat a propellant, such as hydrogen, to produce thrust. This method offers an ideal balance of high thrust and efficiency, which makes it ideal for deep space missions. Recent investments in NTP by NASA and private industry indicate that it could be a transformative technology for missions like Project Lyra, potentially reducing travel times to distant objects significantly. One of the biggest questions surrounding a mission to intercept Oumuamua is whether it is worth the effort. Such a mission could take decades to complete, with significant risks including system failures, communication challenges, and outdated technology by the time of arrival. Additionally, Oumuamua's faint visibility and altered trajectory make tracking it increasingly difficult. The data it yields might not justify the effort, particularly when weighed against other priorities, such as Mars exploration or the development of next-generation telescopes. On the other hand, a mission to study Oumuamua could provide groundbreaking insights into the composition and origins of interstellar objects, answer questions about its unique properties, and drive advancements in propulsion and deep space navigation technologies. Ultimately, the mission is worth pursuing if it aligns with broader interstellar exploration goals, addresses high-priority scientific questions about Oumuamua, and can be achieved without compromising other critical projects. However, it may not be justified if the opportunity costs are too high, or if the risks and uncertainties outweigh the potential scientific benefits. So, to summarize, in 2017, astronomers discovered Oumuamua, the first known interstellar object to pass through our solar system. Its unusual trajectory, shape, and unexplained acceleration defied classification as either a comet or an asteroid, sparking debates about its nature. Theories range from exotic natural phenomena to the possibility of alien technology, but its true origin remains a mystery. Oumuamua left the solar system before enough data could be collected, prompting discussions about intercepting it or preparing for future interstellar objects. Project Lyra has proposed advanced propulsion strategies, including solar sails and Oberth maneuvers, though each option presents significant technical and logistical challenges. While a mission to study Oumuamua could yield valuable insights and drive technological innovation, the high costs, extended timelines, and uncertain scientific returns raise concerns about its feasibility. To justify the risks and resources, such a mission must align with broader scientific goals and demonstrate clear value. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to Lucid Space, and hit the notification bell so you never miss new videos. Until next time, thank you for watching.